For the week of January 16th, 2012, this is the Yokosuka Report on Channel 15, your place for news on the fleet, service members, and our community.
Chief of Navy Chaplains, Rear Admiral Mark Tidd, recently paid a visit to Fleet Activities Yokosuka's Chapel of Hope to meet with area chaplains, religious program specialists, and their spouses. Tidd spoke about his appreciation for the Chaplain Corps and their role in the U.S. Navy.
We've heard many great things about the opportunities to live here, the opportunities for travel, for meeting folks, learning about a different culture, but there are also challenges. So it was important for me to come here and to be able to hear from our people what it's like for them, what the challenges and the opportunities are that they're encountering here.
Lieutenant Benjamin Howard said it was a great chance to meet with the top chaplain in the Navy.
It's a great privilege for us as chaplains to get to hear directly from our direct chain of influence, our chief of chaplains, who tells us what his priorities are and then shares with us stuff that's going on big Navy-wise.
Petty Officer Adrian White, Yokosuka Naval Base, Japan.
The USO in Yokosuka unveiled its newest addition to the center, the Wounded Warrior Room, with the help of some of Yokosuka's United States Naval Hospital personnel, including the commanding officer, Captain Stephen Pachuta. Jua Willett, the programs and marketing director for USO Japan, said the room isn't just for wounded service members, but also for those who have cared for them.
Today we had our grand opening of the Wounded Warrior Relaxation Room. And this room is intended for all of those who've been wounded in the line of duty, but also to those who have provided care to them.
Willett said the room gives personnel a place of their own to sit back and relax.
It's just a way for us to reach out and provide them extra space to relax and, you know, use the internet, kick back in a very comfy chair, play some video games, just get away from it all.
Hospital man Nicholas Burton said the room was a great idea because service members returning to Yokosuka from a deployment often need a place to decompress.
Not everybody has a family to go to or a family they can consult with. They need to be able to take their own time and breathe and enjoy themselves for a little bit of time.
Petty Officer Bryan, Reckard, Yokosuka Naval Base, Japan.
Sailors assigned to Naval Mobile Construction Battalion 40 are used to hard work and long deployments. The difference between this deployment and all others is this will be their last.
I've been with NMCB 40 for almost 2 years now, and I think there's pros and cons to us getting decommissioned. It's a good thing that we're all going to different places and experiencing different things, but at the same time we've accomplished a lot together with the deployment in Afghanistan and this last home port, and it resulted into us getting the Battle E.
NMCB 40 will be decommissioned at the year's end and will be turning over to NMCB 74. Members of the battalion are currently deployed throughout the globe, including Yokosuka, Japan, where they will spend the next 7 months.
Well, I don't think anyone likes to see their legacy end. You know, NMCB 40 has a long legacy. We were commissioned during World War II. We've been around for a long time and we have a reputation, and no one likes to see that go away.
Although originally commissioned in October 1942, called the Fighting 40, NMCB 40 was previously decommissioned in 1945 and remained for 21 years until 1966, where it was recommissioned under the command of Commander Ben Saravia.
I really hope that we go out with a bang, and you know, I know that it was our cycle being decommissioned. It wasn't because we were a bad battalion at all, you know, but I just really hope everybody knows that, and we're going to show them that this last deployment.
This battalion is currently home-ported in Port Hueneme, California, and plans to continue its long-standing reputation of valor and devotion into its last day. Petty Officer Michael Story, Yokosuka Naval Base, Japan.